Preparing for today's video was really difficult because there's not all that much data out there to really give you guys, other than everything's revolving around the Fed right now. So some of the news that we have out today is home sales barely budge from April to May and sluggish spring markets. So usually in the spring markets, people just load up. That's when all the houses come to the market and that's when all the people come out of the woodworks to buy homes. But things are flat right now, and why? Well, the reason why is inventory. And you guys might still think that I'm fooled a bit, but look at the caption right next to this. Low U.S. housing inventory is an opportunity for home builders. We're going to talk about that at the end of the video because many people said home builders, they're going out of business. They're going bankrupt. They're going bust. Well, let's see how their financials are actually looking. But let's go over some of the details that we have for today, some of the economic calendar events. Yesterday, we had building permits. They killed it. And this is a wrong number. This is supposed to be 1.6 something. So I don't know why they have it in here because all the analysts and all the other data has this correctly. So previously, we had home building permits at 1.1 million. It skyrocketed all the way up to 1.6 million. So let's forward fast to today, though, which is Thursday. The Fed keeps saying, you know, we need the jobs market to really get hammered so people are forced to stop spending. Well, I'm kind of contradicting with that, and I'm going to give you a little bit of data, but I won't bore you to death on that. But let's go over this right now. Initial jobless claims, 264,000, a little bit higher than was expected. Existing home sales, we just talked about that, those are flat. I'm okay with flat. When you really look at them in detail, not just pockets in the whole nation, if you look at it in detail, house values at 350,000 and less, they're selling like hotcakes. They're selling everywhere within probably weeks. So if you don't believe me, call your realtor. I can assure you, if you tell them you want a $250,000 house, they're gonna like, well, get in line because everybody else does too. Existing home sales, we just went over there. Now, Federal Chairman Powell, he runs the Fed. He's the grand poobah. He's in front of the banking committee today. Talking. Yesterday, he sued the markets a little bit, and I posted a video last night. Nowhere in his context yesterday, nowhere in writing, and nowhere in the transcripts of what they said says that they're going to raise rates two more times. So I'm kind of skittish about that. Some of the jobs numbers is really where I want to focus in on today, because this is really the only economic data we have. But I want you to look at something. So I studied the jobs reports from 2007, 2008, when basically the world was imploding and everything was bad. And what happened was education and what was the other thing? Healthcare took the charts. They were the most robust piece of the economy that was adding jobs. And then we went through COVID and everybody in healthcare was working. But then right after there, you know, tons of people left, tons of people lost their jobs, tons of people didn't get vaccinated, so they lost their jobs and all that other stuff. So if you look at that sector, that education and government, those are areas where it doesn't matter if you're sick or you're, you know, you got money or you don't. If you get sick, you're going to the hospital. So the hospital has to be, you know, has to have workers. Same thing with education. Now that education, the kids are back to school, we're going to see education numbers skyrocketing. But the frustrating thing here is, let me get my head out of the way. The backbone of our country is what? Construction and manufacturing. Look at those numbers. Look at manufacturing. It's a negative. They're losing money there. Construction, you know, it's up 25,000. But look at the areas that really are going nuts. Education, healthcare, government, business services, whatever, then hospitality. So really when you get to the bones of the industry in this country, it's down through these areas through here. Okay, so again, manufacturing, losing jobs. So that's one area I want to focus you guys in on. The next is, here's all the data in one. So this is basically what I see on my computer all day long. So I usually go to different websites to show you guys this, but I just want to give you a little bit of caption. This is the economic calendar for today. Jobless claims came out. And again, this gives us a little more detail. The previous reading was 264. It was revised to 262. They thought it was going to come in at 260. It came in at 264. So we got more people that just lost their jobs. Continued claims, previous reading was 1772. It was revised to 1775. Now it come in at 1759. Okay, that's okay. It's staying steady. Existing home sales, steady. What's it? Leading indicators. Now, this is where the negatives start to come in. We have leading indicators was negative 0.6 previously, coming at negative 0.7 previously. And then oil, we are not even going to focus in on oil. So now let's get over to, everybody keeps saying the housing market's going to crash. This is going on. Home builders are going out of business, all this other stuff. So let's go into what their stock prices are doing, because we know the construction, their sentiment is keeps going up and up and up. And the whole beast behind that is just no inventory. People with existing homes aren't selling. So let's get over to the stock prices of the top three home builders in the country right now. So we have, which one is this? This is Lennar Corporation, home builder. All right, here's where their stock prices went so far this year. Started at 90 and today is at 120. I'll take that. Huge gain. $30 a share that's up. Not a bad return on your money there. Let's go to the next one. Which one is this? This is D.R. Horton. Let's look at their stock price. Started the year at right about 90 as well. Where are we right now? 119, 120. Kind of very similar to the previous one. And then let's go to the last one. Pulte. Here's Pulte's price. Where was it? Well, at the beginning of the year, is it 46? Where is it now? 75? So, does this stock look like a price of a company that's going out of business, going bankrupt? No. So I want you guys at least to get to the point where saying, okay, guys, I hope you just admit there's not a crash. There's not a crash here. There's not a crash now. And I don't forecast a crash in the next year because of inventory and so forth. So then I have some comments on YouTube that are people who are comment down below. It's like, well, Dan, it's going to take, you know, 7 years for the cycle to run. But I ask the question, where are you getting your data? Okay, so what I try to do on a daily basis is at least provide you with my thoughts, and then I try to back it up with all the information I can provide for you on the web that you can do on your own. So basically, the gist of today is, relax, people. If you're looking to buy a house, house affordability is basically in your lap. And I hate to say it that way. What's affordable to you in your areas? I have a lot of people calling from California, and they're like, Dan, we can't buy a house. Well, unfortunately, you choose to live in that area. If I live downtown New York, couldn't afford it. Okay, I can't afford it. So I don't move to downtown New York. If I move there, I might have to live with a couple people and rent a little apartment, but that would be my choice. So if you have a choice and you're looking, you know, for home ownership, California might not be your answer, okay? Or the local area that you're in might not be, you know, fit for you, your affordability, okay? So I hate to say it that way, but unfortunately, that's just how everything works. So the next thing we want to go is with the data that we have out today, which is really nothing. It's basically Federal Chairman Powell speaking in front of Congress or the Banking Committee. What's going on with mortgage rates? So for that, we go over to the MBS markets. And so we're seeing this right now. So this is the bond that trades on Wall Street. It's the mortgage-backed security bond. We focus in on it because it's the mortgage-backed security bond. It's the bond that's yield is the biggest determining factor of your mortgage rate. Okay, so that's what this number is, or this area is here. What you're seeing right through here is the price of the bond. It's 98.20. It is down 0.38. All you need to know within this, if the number's down, rates are going up. Okay, and you can see this. It's down, 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 and down today, and probably because Federal Chairman Powell is speaking in front of the Banking Committee, and they don't know what he's going to say, so everybody's cautious right now. So as we saw yesterday, if you look back yesterday, we had a big rally into the day, and then it crushed at the end of the day. So this is a two-day chart. You can go through here. The testimony started with Federal Chairman Powell here. It moved up all day long, and then today we're crashing with the new news of whatever he's coming out with yet. I have not watched that news on what his questions and answers are. So that's it for today. The last thing is, let's go over where mortgage rates are. Where are mortgage rates today? Well, this is where they ended yesterday. From Mortgage News Daily, they post this all the time, and they recalculated throughout the day. So if you want this chart, just check down below and it'll give you some ideas on where mortgage rates are today. These are the top six products people use when they're buying or refinancing a house. The gist behind all these numbers is this. If you're looking to buy your first house, it's your primary home and a single family home. Those three things, and you have a 740 credit score and you put 20% down, that would be your rate. You don't need to put 20% down. Most people go with an FHA loan or a first-time homebuyer program that only requires 3% down. But did you know we actually have that 3% down program? But we're going to give you 2% in grant money, so you're only going to have to come out with 1% of a down payment. If you want to check out that program, all you need to do is click this video up through here. So without further ado, that's it for today, guys. My name is Dan Frio. I'm a mortgage advisor. I help people all over the country. I work for a federally chartered bank, which allows me to lend anywhere in the country, but we're also one of the country's largest mortgage brokerages. So that allows me to use my products and rates, as well as about 70 or 80 different lenders out there, the country's largest lenders. I can use their programs and their rates as well. So where else should you go other than a one-stop shop? And that's us here. So to reach out to us at the Frio team, how do you do that? Well, it's pretty simple. You can give us a call, 844-775-5626. Or if you're like, hey, Dan, I just need your help. Let's get this thing rolling. Well, click the apply now button. It's right over here. Or if you're like, Dan, I got a ton of questions and I can't get you during the day because I'm working. Is there something I can do? Absolutely. You can schedule an appointment down below. It says schedule a consultation with me or one of my mortgage advisors. We're here to answer any questions that you guys have. So thanks so much for watching, folks. God bless. I'll see you tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.